Hi, my name is Mrs. Williams, and I teach at Smithfield Middle School. I teach 8th grade physical science. I have been in the JSAT program since 2011, and it's a great program. Today, I'm going to go over a mini lab that we have done in JSAT. I'm going to do a virtual version and also an in-class version. So the first version I want to show you is my in-class version. And this is a mini lab. It's great for an introduction to elements, compounds, and mixture, or for maybe a review. It's about 10 minutes long. And these are the materials that you're going to need to create this lab. And here's the lab setup. So you need tiny petri dishes, and you've got elements, compounds, and mixtures, and there's three of each. And when you finish, this is what it looks like. Now you can label them anything you would like. These are the letters that I chose. And the top picture is how I store this lab. Now, if you were in class, I would scatter these dishes all throughout the room, and they would go look at each of the dishes. They have to decide if it's an element, compound, or mixture. And this is a lab write-up that you have. In picture A, B, and C, they just draw a diagram of element, compound, and mixture. And at the bottom, they fill in element, compound, and mixture. It really is a great lab, and it's super easy. Now, we also have a virtual element, compound, and mixture mini lab. So this is a drag and drop. So I found for my virtual students that drag and drop is a little more interactive and they really enjoy this. So the first one is it, drag and drop, element, compound, and mixture. And then here's some more pictures of an element, compound, and mixture, they drag and drop. And then again, some more pictures, black and white pictures. Another element, compound, and mixture. Now we're gonna do mixtures of elements, mixtures of compounds, and mixtures of elements and compounds. And they drag and drop those also. Now, this is the part of the in-class lab. I took pictures of what I did, and this is the virtual part. So they have to drag and drop which one of these looks like an element. So obviously B would be an element because they're all the same. And next one would be a compound, two or more. So that would be W, and then obviously mixture would be D. And so these are all the petri dishes that I would do my normal in-class. I took pictures of them, and it's a drag and drop. And continue. And then these are questions for element, compound, and mixture, definitions, what are they made up of, drag and drop again. And here is a periodic table of elements. This is to answer these questions. So this lab is a little more detailed than my in-class mini lab. It has more questions. They can go more in depth with this one. And here they decide if it's an element, compound, and mixture based on the elements. And here's examples of an element, compound, and mixture, drag and drop. Again, here's some more examples. And then the last slide is some questions that they need to answer about elements, compounds, and mixtures. And then I have the element answer key. So after we do the lab virtually, we go over the answer key and they check their work. Obviously, element, compound, and mixture, the drag and drop examples, the mixture of elements, mixture of compounds, mixture of elements and compounds. And then of course the petri dishes, which is like the in-class version, elements, compounds, and mixtures. And then of course the element, compound, and mixtures, explanations, definitions, and answers to, again, element, compound, and mixture. So this is a great lab. Again, the virtual one goes a little more in depth than my in-class version. But both of them are awesome and you can use them in your class. I hope you enjoyed this and I hope you learned something. Have a great day.